All right, now this is Micah chapter 6, verse 1. Hear ye now what the Lord saith, Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai. Arise, contend thou before the mountains, and let the hills hear thy voice. Hear ye, O mountains, the Lord's controversy, and ye strong foundations of the earth. For the Lord hath a controversy with his people, and he will plead with Israel. O my people, what have I done unto thee? And wherein have I wearied thee? Testify against me, for I brought thee up out of the land of Egypt, and redeemed thee out of the house of servants, and I sent before thee Moses and Aaron and Miriam. O my people, remember now what Balak, king of Moab, consulted, and what Balaam, the son of Beor, answered him from Shittim unto Gilgal, that ye may know the righteousness of the Lord. Wherewith shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before the high power? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves of a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, or with the 10,000s of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression of the fruit of my body, for the sin of my soul? He has showed me, O man, what is good, and what doeth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy power. The Lord's voice crieth unto the city, and the man of wisdom shall see thy name. Hear ye the rod, and who hath appointed it? Are ye yet the treasures of wickedness in the house of the wicked, and the scant measure that is abominable? Shall I not count them pure with the wicked balances, and with the bag of deceitful weight? For the rich man thereof are full of violence, and inhabitants thereof have spoken lies, and their tongue is deceitful in their mouth. Therefore also I will make thee sick in smiting thee, and making thee desolate because of thy sin. Thou shalt eat, but not be satisfied, and thou shalt cast down, and shalt be in the midst of thee, and thou shalt take hold, but shalt not deliver, and that which thou deliverest will I give up to the sword. Thou shalt sow, but thou shalt not reap. Thou shalt trim the olive, but thou shalt not anoint thee with oil, and sweet wine, but shalt not drink wine. For the statutes of Omri are kept, and all the works of the house of Ahab, and ye walk in their counsel, that I should make thee a desolation, and the inhabitants thereof a hissing. Therefore ye shall bear your reproach of my people. The reproach of the people. So we are a reproach unto all nations. That's another reason why all nations don't like us. Because we don't benefit them. We hurt them. We curse them. And not just cursing that comes out of our tongue, but just the presence of us is a curse. It's a reproach unto them. That's why they call us bywords. And those bywords were given to the Lord, for the Lord to give to them, those other nations, to call us, to provoke us to jealousy. The Most High is giving the wicked everything to provoke you Israelites to jealousy. Alright? Just like when Moses stated, I'm going to send a nation to you that's not even a nation, and they shall provoke you to jealousy. Now the nation that's not a nation is who? The so-called Edomites, the so-called white people. Alright, now when we say Edomites, yeah, we talk about the white people, but we also say, when we say the so-called white man and the Edomites, we're also talking about the state of mind. Alright, not just your skin tone. I don't really deal with your skin tone, because there's Israelites that have the skin tone of white people. Alright, and then there's Esau that got the skin tone of Jake. Therefore, we don't deal with the skin tone. Alright, that's why the scripture says, look for the Jew that's inwardly and not the one that's outwardly. Right? Because if I just go and just talk to everybody who's outwardly and not the ones that's inwardly, then I'm not getting all of Israel. But if I get the ones that's inwardly, and how do I know that you're the inwardly? Because of the words that come out your mouth. Alright? That means if you have scriptures, and you could back it up with what you're saying, and you got scriptures to back up everything that you say, and you understand Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai, then yeah, you're coming home, man. Come home. All right, we're here to bring all the people back home of Israel. All right, and when I say all the people, I'm talking about one third. I'm not talking about all Israel. All right, because two thirds of Israel is not going to hearken. So I'm not here for you. I'm only here for 144,000 and one third of the children of Israel. All right, we go to Zechariah chapter 12. This is Zechariah chapter 12, verse 6. In that day will I make the governors of Judah like a heart of fire among wood, and like a torch of fire in a sheath, and they shall devour all the people round about, on the right hand and on the left. And Jerusalem shall be inhabited again in her own place, even in Jerusalem. Alright? So the Most High has made us a fiery spirit. And when those ICBM missiles come and burn up everything, we're already fire. Fire cannot devour another fire. It's one and the same. Just like water cannot devour some more water. They're one and the same. Alright? Everybody that's on the left-hand side of us and everybody that's on the right-hand side of us, when the Most High gives us that call and let us know it's time to strike, we are not going to hesitate. We will strike on both sides. All right, the only ones that won't get hit is the ones that come in spirit and in truth for Yahweh Ba'al Shem Yahweh Shah. All right? Shalom, Akyam.